So my name is Ads Terak van Schijndel. In Brazil, especially the ladies, pronounce my first name as Adje. If you ever go to Brazil, just say your name is Adje and let them pronounce that. That's very nice. All right, well, SimpleGov. That's a project that we have been working on for a little over a year now. And it really has taken our company to a next level in terms of usability. And I'm going to show what that means to us. And I'm going to show some things that we developed in this project and that also may be of use for the community. So what is this presentation about? First, a little bit about how we got here, in what steps. I started Wikibase Solutions in 2012 on my own. Let's see where we are now. A short introduction on SimpleGov, on the project and the business case of what it's about. SimpleGov is a large platform. It has a lot of data in it, and it's very demanding on usability. So we started with SMW, then we went to Cargo, but we ended up creating our own storage extension, and the same goes for forms. We still are using page forms, but I'm going to show an extension that we developed and what it can do for a platform such as SimpleGov. All right, as I said, Wikibase Solutions, I founded Wikibase Solutions in 2012, especially rapidly growing last year. We are employing 8 developers now, not all of them full-time. We have students part-time that have a few hours left in the week to work for us. They really like that. We really like to create, and we see that our customers, our best customers, are the customers that really have ambitions. They want to, do things that are difficult with software that is in the market or for whom it's too expensive, or it takes too much time to build custom solutions. We really fit in a hole there. And these customers really like us for our speed, reliability, and flexibility. And I think that counts for both the software, so we can develop very rapidly, and the software proves very flexible and reliable. And I think they also think the same about the team. And we have global client base. Our largest customer is SimpleGov, and is located in is based in LA. So what I thought when I created this presentation, we really started, or you could say I really started, with plain media wiki, with semantic media wiki page forms and semantic result formats. I didn't know anything about PHP or HTML or CSS. So I became very good at using the standard extensions, and I think we created some very nice solutions, but they really look like this. This is the plain media wiki look and feel that we still love and we still can use, especially for internal projects. But it has its limitations. And of course, we as a company, we developed skills, and we met the chameleon skin, which uses Bootstrap, got to know HTML, CSS, and then we got to the next level and created wikis. And this one I presented for the first time, I think, in Barcelona. And we were very proud of this. we created wikis that had a much better look and feel, that are responsive. And I think this is really this really was the next level then. But by now we are creating custom extensions. I'm going to talk about that. We get to know JavaScript, third-party libraries that can be used very well. So I'm going to show you a few examples. But if you do that and if you gain expertise to do all that, then a totally new world opens up and you can do things that you didn't think were possible. So this is the front page of SimpleGov. That's the application, the platform I'm going to talk to you about. And I'm going to show what we did, what got us to the next level. But it's all based, and that's it was like that in 2012, still like that. The foundation is still MediaWiki. And I think it will be. Okay, SimpleGov is about a platform. And this is our customer. He is in California. He's quite famous. He's a successful internet entrepreneur, and he chose us for his next project. And what he says, he's a smart guy. He says, well, I can choose WordPress for my next project, but he figures that MediaWiki is a very powerful and stable and reliable platform to build the next project. So I think when these guys think that MediaWiki is the right platform, I think much more people, organizations should make the same decision. SimpleGov is about creating changes. It's a bit like changes.org. Perhaps you know changes.org. You can create initiatives, put them on the side, turn them into projects. But the unique element here is that all government officials, all government agencies, are in the wiki. So you are connecting your project to agencies and officials that have to do with that specific problem. And you are going to engage in a dialogue with the official that has something to say about it. So all the information about all government agencies and officials is in the wiki. Right now it's really focused on California, but it means that at the moment there are 50,000 jurisdictions, cities, counties, states in the system, 50,000 agencies and 50,000 officials. I'm going to show you a little, a very small, no, this was not what I meant. This is not what I had in mind. Well, I'm going to do it like, it seems I have to stop the presentation for a moment. All right. So, like I said, SimpleGov is about projects, and having the projects linked to the officials and the agencies that have to do with that project. And as you can see, well, at least I think that it looks nice. And it has some usability features, I think, that are not very common to wikis. For example, this is the project. You describe the problem. People can suggest solutions. You can have a solution that is the preferred solution. And you can, the agencies and officials that are involved. And you can rate a proposed solution. And of course, ordinary users don't want to. You have to remember everything is MediaWiki, so everything is a page, so it's the same as MediaWiki. But if you want to rate a solution, you don't want to go to a page, edit it, and then do something. You just want to do something like this. Choose. Yeah, he wants it to have very fine-grained vote, but you want to be able to vote. Oh, sorry. Yeah, I have to log in first. I think. Yeah, this is of course also a small detail. Oh. Right. Okay. Well, I'm logged in now, so he knows me. So if I want to rate this, this is what I want, something like this. And if I vote, then the vote immediately gets the new value. And this is one of my favorite things, I'll show you why. If you want to suggest a solution, you want to be able to add information on the page itself. I'll show you why this is one of my favorites, because we are in the world of fake news at the moment. And what the SimpleGov guy wants is to be able to, of course, to register a solution for yourself, as yourself, but also to be able to have some random user creating or registering a solution. And you can even generate a new person, register a solution, and a proposed solution. And then submit. And what happens when you submit? Then not only the solution is registered, but also the user is created. So multiple things are going on after you suggest this solution. All right, I'm not going to dive too deep in SimpleGov itself. I want to show you information, things about the extensions that we created. But this list is also of great interest to our customer and to the users, because you want to know and to understand a lot of aspects about a project. You want to know if people are interested in it, if people like it. So there's a lot of information that has to be presented on these pages. Okay, let's get back to the presentation. See how that works. Yeah, works okay. A little bit about the data storage in SimpleGov. We started with Semantic Media Wiki and with Cargo. But we decided to for several reasons, to create an extension of our own. The basics are the same as Semantic Media Weekend Cargo, but there are some important differences. For example, if you have a lot of, if you want to import 50,000 pages and you want to be, and you want all the data to be in the database with Semantic Media Wiki and Cargo, that takes a lot of time. And it puts a lot of jobs in the queue. And there's a lot of activity going on that is really not needed, because the only thing you want is to have the data from the page put in the database. And with, if you have an extension of your own, you can do that any way you specifically like it and you specifically need it. So that's what we are doing. If you want to add additional information about pages, such as ratings, you can do that in the, with the same mechanism as well. We used I think it was the rating system that was, I think it was initially created by Yuri Katkov, and we changed that a little bit, but the data is in our database, so we can link it and query it with together with all the other information about officials, about projects, about officials. Of course, we need sometimes very fast queries. If you have to choose a person from a list of 50 or 100,000 people and you want instant result, you might have to do some specific things. And I think, I'm not entirely sure, but I think also lazy loading is implemented in our extension. Because I'm not a developer, I'm only the boss, and our developers do all these very nice things that we are very proud of. Okay. Yeah, it was a long wish of ours, Jaron knows it, to have forms on pages, not as a separate form, a separate page, but on the pages itself. Also page, forms that can edit or create multiple pages at the same time, because sometimes you have a some information on the page that really consists, we are going to have a look at it later, of projects, officials, agencies at the same time, and you want to be able to edit information about perhaps more than one page and to see what it looks like in combination and then submit. And of course you want to be able to submit actions, other actions such as register user, you saw that was done, upload files, send emails, callbacks, that means I'll show you examples later. But I think anything really. Okay, I'm going to show you a few demos of what we do with the forms and how it looks like, what it looks like. We call it WS Form. That's just the name of the extension. And you can just define your form on any page. And the way you do that is as close to ordinary HTML forms as possible. So we are using HTML standards to describe and to define the forms. And what you see here is that, well, we create a field, a form with a field of type file. This is the name of the file that we want to be used. Here it says force JPEG, because people don't always upload the right format, and you want them. And you, sometimes you want automatic conversion from PNG to JPEG, for example. This is some technical stuff that I really don't understand. It seems that HTML wants this. So it's good practice to adhere to this standard. You can have it's perfectly clear that I didn't make this film. I would have chosen a picture of Mark, probably. Or Marilyn Monroe, yeah. Okay, so what we want to show, it's easy to create, to define a form. You can upload a file, but underneath it's still the same media wiki. So you can do anything that you want with it. So this was a small demonstration of the file upload. If you have questions about it, you can ask me and perhaps I might be able to answer it. This is an example of what we have in the extension at this moment. Essentially, all the usual HTML fields are allowed. When defining the form, you define what the basic action is. You define some parameters that are necessary for processing, what you want to do with it, add a page, what kind of where you want to go after submit, all that kind of things. We have integrated also the select field library, I think it is, to be able to support multiple, I really am not sure what the select field essentially supports, I must say. But if a form looks like that, so it is not very difficult to do. And because you use standard HTML stuff, you have a standard way of checking the form. So if you submit and there's something not right in the form, you can easily correct it. All right. So if you have questions about this form, please ask it. What I'm going to show you now is what I think is the most interesting demonstration of and the most interesting advantages of having forms on the page itself. Because here, this is functionality that is not available for any visitor of this platform, but is really meant for people maintaining the information on the... Oh, it's going already. Really for people maintaining the information. So, for example, you want to be able to maintain the information about a specific agency. In this case, we are going to have a look at the Houston Fire Department. And here you are on a page that is really... It shows information about the Houston Fire Department, but it's all forms, because essentially you are on the page in edit mode. So it's not a usual page. It's really a form page, and it has a lot of information together, because it has information about the agency itself, but also about some officials. We have one official attached to this agency, fire chief. You can add an official. So you have a bunch of pages of objects together, and you can edit them together. Well, this is one of the things that is very important to us. Is that you can add to input fields, you can add JavaScript things and libraries. So there's there are things in the extension that make it more easy for you to do that. Here, for example, we have an input, this is quite a complex input thing. And it shows all the issues that could be covered by agencies. So for one agency, you have to select some issues the agency covers. When you want to go to the officials, in this case the fire chief. A fire chief is an official. An official has a page, but an official is not yet a person. It's a fire chief. You always have a fire chief, but you don't always have the same person being the fire chief in the Houston Fire Department. So there's information about the official, and there's information about the office terms, and then you attach people in terms. You attach people to the official. Again, we are still in edit mode on this page, so it's only forms we are working with. And in this case, he wants to wants to connect a person to an official. So say, well, this guy was the fire chief in that period of time, but he's not there in the system yet. So you want to add him. So what you want is to, what happens here is that you get a modal page with a form that enables you to create a person. So this is quite an ordinary form. And if you hit save, this person is saved, but additionally, when you hit the save button, the information of this person is transferred to the other form. So that's an example of being able to perform multiple actions when you hit the save button. Yeah, this is one we also like very much. Of course, ordinary users really want to be able to upload images and to work with images very easily. And there are some libraries around, and this is a library that you have to pay for, that we connected to this input field. But it enables you to drag the image and to be able to crop the image, as you can see. So it's easy to crop, and you can have a square or I think other types of crops. And so what we have here is one form, and the upload of the picture is a separate form. So what you do, you have the same field that we had before, only with this library behind it that enables you to process that image. But essentially, it's the same thing that happens. You upload the file, and the information about this person is registered on a wiki page and connected to the term. So this right now the page is updated. This was the first time that you saw that page was updated. All the other updates were done in the background, and the page was the edit page. The form was updated with Ajax in real time. So that is something that is in the form as well. Updates can be processed in the form at real time. So if you stay in the form, you don't need to reload the page. And that's, of course, for ordinary users is important because it makes it more usable and user-friendly. Okay. Well, this I think I showed a few things that in our view make a wiki much more user-friendly and much more easy to use for, let's say, the public. And that is to us a next level, and that means that we can have customers that like such things. And I'm really looking forward to working together, for example, with Lex, because these companies, they want and the intelligence in the engine, in the mid layer, and they want the usability, easy to use and like any modern website. So I think we are really heading there. I think we are also seeing some elements of the next level in this project. I've been thinking about that, but we are working on widgets, because SimpleGov right now is not much more than a maintenance platform, but our customer is negotiating right now with the ACLU to have widgets on the ACLU websites linking to projects in SimpleGov, so that from the ACLU website you have a small view on a project and that you can rate and see information and rate officials and projects and suggested solutions on the ACLU website, things like that. And we had lunch with our customer yesterday in LA, and he said to us, what you should do, he said, you should integrate wikis with Slack. He said, all large organizations are using Slack nowadays. You should integrate wikis with Slack. And
I disagree.
He disagrees. Slack is a popular solution for communicating with. Perhaps you can explain better, Mark.
I just disagree. I hate Slack. So.
You hate Slack?
Yeah, many people love it.
Many people love it. Yeah, so you can chat. But what is interesting about Slack, that it shows, now and then it shows integration with other sites or other things. So if you're talking to a colleague and you get a question, that's one of the things that Slack is used for very much, that people ask questions to each other. Wouldn't it be interesting if you could say, well, I'm not going to give the answer in Slack, but I'm going to send a link to a page on a wiki that explains what this guy should know. But then, of course, you don't want to type the whole link, but you want to have some integration that you can.
Right, so you could have search integration with your wiki now.
Yeah.
So I think
the widgets and the Slack integration and other kinds of integration, I think that's going to be the next level for us.
So are you ready for questions?
Yes.
Okay. I have a question. I see your semantic media wiki and page forms and all that. I didn't see a lot of long form writing, I guess, that I associate more with wikis, you know. Maybe that's just me. But how do you use how is media wiki used in the back end here underneath all the beautiful
and not only how but also why? Or did I explain the why?
That would also be good.
Yeah. Well, I think we are in Dutch they would say you are a strange duck in the pond or something like that. We we have been using MediaWiki for business solutions, not necessarily as wikis, but as a foundation for platform for business solutions. Sometimes they are really wiki-like, but not always. In this case, not really.
So even if you don't have that focus of long form text as the focus, you could, it seems, if someone wanted to, could they use the wiki underneath here? If they had a reason.
Yes.
Okay.
Definitely. Yeah, because underneath the same, if you go to the URL and you say new page, action is added, the same,
okay.
the same thing happens. Yeah, it's exactly the same thing. I really like it that you ask it, because it, you asking that means that you don't see that from the site that you're looking at.
Right.
Right. Okay, some more questions.
So basically, when you create the form, what goes into the page? Is it a template call?
Yeah, exactly the same. Yeah. Yeah.
Well, I noticed you had a password input as one of the input types. Is that even usable if it's just going into the wiki page?
No, I don't think so. I said exactly the same thing to the guy who made this demonstration. I said, how is it put on the page? So I agree. But he thought it was nice to show the no. Yeah. I had the same question.
And my other question was, so it seems like you only showed the edit mode. How do people move back and forth between edit and view mode?
The same. But here on this specific page in the last movie. Yeah, there is really no view mode. It's only a form on the page. There is no view mode. If on the other page, wait a minute. Over here, you have view mode and form at the same time. And this is just a collapsible. There is collapsible bootstrap Stefan Gamke thing. So that's very much the way we do things.
Yes. I saw you did some work with the chameleon scanning. Is that released as a custom skin, or is it just like local tweaks and modifications to Chameleon?
I don't think any custom tweaks. I think plain Chameleon. I think the layout of the wiki is just plain Chameleon.
Okay.
Yeah. Not yet, but we think that, we want to do that.
I think you want to as well.
Yeah. Yeah, but it's of course, there are still a lot of things that page forms can do that we can't do. But, and we are using the both together. And I think they are really quite complementary.
I confess, how does the integration work with Semantic MediaWiki or Arcargo or something? Of forms and stuff like that. Is it all stored in wiki text as,
everything is stored in wiki text, and then in the template you can have and a storage thing that you store in our SSDs, SimpleGov storage of data, I think it was called. And cargo or SNW at the same time. Yeah.
Where is it being used? Who's using it?
On this SimpleGov site, and we are using it more and more on for other customers. Well, of course, this is our largest customer. No. This is a platform. Well, this platform is not for there's a lot of government information, but the government has nothing to do with it. So it's a private initiative to create such a platform to enable people to start projects, to start changes, and to link them to government. But we are using the same technology we are using for customers in the Netherlands. We have a joint venture with a consulting firm that has a methodology in Dutch we call it mission-driven organization. It's about organizing projects within an organization, and there we also find that if we want people to use it, it's very, very important to have a low threshold for using it. So ease of use, usability is very, very important, and then such things become very important. So we see that when that is important, and in places when it is important, we really are moving to this way of these kind of forms. Yeah. Okay. Thank you.